All right, here's what you don't need to make attractive thumbnails. You don't need a degree in graphic design, you don't need to be creative, and you don't need to pay for any software. Here's what you do need to make attractive thumbnails. You need any free software that you can find on the internet. And second thing is, you need to watch this video. Yo, Mr. Mob, my name is Rayo, and I've got a couple of requests from you asking how to make attractive thumbnails, either for YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, whatever it is. And in this video, I'm gonna show you exactly how to do that. And I'm gonna show you by making it a thumbnail of this video you're currently watching right now. Obviously, you already know what it looks like because, well, you clicked on it, but I don't as of yet, but we will see. And I'm sure the whole process to the start till the end is gonna be really interesting to watch, and I'm gonna give you some simple tips on how you can make attractive thumbnails that are clickable even when you have no clue about design. Also, if this is the type of content you would like to see more, then make sure you subscribe with the notification bell on. So first thing you need to know about thumbnails is that they do affect your views a lot, along with the title, of course. You can have an amazing video, but if your thumbnail looks like a 6-year-old just discovered a program called Paint on his mom's computer, then, well, nobody's gonna click on your video. The good thing is that on YouTube, you can see exactly how well your title and thumbnail is performing, and then you can make adjustments based on the feedback you get from the analytics. But important thing about the analytics is that you don't get too attached to them. Yes, they help you, but if you've been watching your YouTube analytics for like at least 5 times per day, then make sure you check out this video here. All right, so what does make a thumbnail attractive? Well, the simplest way to put it is that an attractive thumbnail supports the title, and they work together, and combined, they create emotion in the viewer, and they, they pique the viewer's interest. And this is what makes them click on the video. Besides attractive thumbnails, do you know what else is attractive? That's right, the people who hit that like button for the YouTube algorithm, so more people who want to learn more about thumbnails can see this video. One thing that makes your viewers bored of you, even if they have a chance to watch your videos, is having a thumbnail that's pretty much the exact same copy as your title, but just in visual form. You want to avoid at all costs making your thumbnails look like they're just a duplicate of your title. So what you want to do here is avoid writing things in a thumbnail that you already have written in the title. Instead, work on creating a title and a thumbnail that support each other, so they create more emotion and more interest. Anyways, let me jump on my PC here and let's get started. All right, and here we are. I do want to say that I usually use Photoshop for all my photo editing stuff, but as usual, for the sake of this video, I want to help you out, so I'm gonna use a free browser-based software called Canva. Let's open up Canva here. And on the front page, the first thing you'll see is that there are hundreds of different templates you can choose from. And we can just go on and choose a YouTube thumbnail template here. It's gonna create a canvas that's exactly the correct size for our thumbnails. You can choose from all of these templates, but I'm not gonna do that. Instead, I'm gonna create my own. And so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna upload my own picture here. Oh, I have actually my own background here, so I'm gonna use that as a background. And since I want to show you all the steps throughout this process, then I'm just gonna tell you that I got my background from a Google image search, so nothing special about that. Obviously, your background doesn't have to be anything related to colors. It can be a game you're playing, maybe it's CSGO, maybe it's some other game, but the whole point about background is that you want to be consistent with your background throughout your videos, or throughout the topics of your videos. So let me show you an example. If you go to my channel right now, pretty much all my videos have the exact same background, almost. And even on my other channel, where I did CSGO stuff, mostly I had a really consistent background. You can have different backgrounds for different types of content, for sure, but your theme throughout your channel should be still consistent. Alright, let's go back. And now I want to put myself in the thumbnail here, because that's also something that's consistent about my channel. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna move this microphone a little bit. Sorry about that. I'm gonna pose a little bit for you guys, and hopefully we'll get a good screenshot for the thumbnail here. Just for your information, I'm gonna go for a look that says, "Look at how easy it is," or something similar. We'll see.
Fuck, I'm not really good at this, to be honest.
All right, guys, you gotta promise that you're not gonna make fun of me for doing these faces for you here. Sorry about the microphone, but it's something you gotta do for YouTube, your YouTube videos. I know it looks super weird, but you know, it is what it is. All right, I'm gonna take my camera for a second here and I'm gonna put this footage in my PC and then we're gonna take this screenshot into the Canva here. All right, well, I'm back. I got the footage. It's right here. Let's see what we got. Well, the first thing I notice is that I'm extremely out of focus. Wait, this player is not good enough. Let me open it in another player. Oh yeah, this is much better. Okay, so I have to use something like... I'm too close. And here I'm out of focus. Well, that's not good. But I guess it will have to do. Okay, screenshot. Take it. I think it's fine that it's not totally in focus. That shouldn't be a problem for us. Okay, what we need to do now, as you can see, we have the image here, but there's this whole background here. We need to get rid of that, and it's really easy to do it. All you gotta do is go to Google, type background remover, and there you go. It's called remove.bg, upload an image here, get rid of everything. And I'm just gonna click download here. And now what we can finally do is get this picture on our Canva. I do want to flip it. Yeah, that's much better. The picture itself is a little bit pixelated, I know that, but I want to show you that it doesn't matter at all. So if I go here and I zoom out, and make it look like an actual thumbnail, because, you know, an actual thumbnail is gonna be really small, then you don't even notice that it's a little bit pixelated. So, okay, let's go back. And now we're pretty much done already, but there's one more thing missing. We need to add text. And text is really easy to add. Just add a heading. We're gonna write here something like, so easy. Because why the hell not? I am gonna change the font to my favorite one here, which is of course Passion One, if I could write this correctly here. And there we have it. So easy. I'm gonna make it much bigger because that's really something we want to emphasize on it. We want to emphasize on how easy it really is. So the thumbnail so far looks okay-ish, but it's a little bit empty still. So I'm gonna add something to the text here. And because I can't add any shadows to the text here, then what I can do is go to elements and take this thing here and put it behind. Well, we will change the color, of course, and just position it here behind the text, make it smaller. All right, so we have the image here. We have the three most basic things we need for a thumbnail. We have the background, we have the subject, and we have some text, and hopefully they will work together to support the title of this video. But it does look a little bit meh currently, and we don't want to do anything fancy anyways, but I am gonna add just a couple more things to make it a little bit better. So with this here, I'm just gonna make this bigger, and then I'm gonna go to the adjust panel here, and there we can make this. I'm gonna leave the brightness to zero, but I am gonna bring up the contrast a lot because the original picture is not contrasted at all. I'm also gonna bring up the saturation to give me some color, otherwise I'm gonna look like I've never been to outside, which is basically true, but we wanna at least look like we do anyways. And another thing I wanna do is, I don't actually like the so easy title I wrote here, so I'm gonna instead replace it with easy thumbnail. Well, it's gonna go right here, but I'm gonna make it smaller. And you can see it looks really weird right now, but we can adjust this by going to spacing and line height and bring it all the way down. I really want to do something with the background here as well, because it's not looking great right now. We're gonna make it a little bit bigger, and I'm gonna bring the opacity down actually by going to the transparency section here and just bringing it down to, let's say, 50 48. Yeah, I think that looks a lot better here. And let's bring it up here, bring the title here as well. Yeah, I think that looks fine. Now we will add a YouTube title, a YouTube icon here as well. Maybe I should put it this way instead. I think this looks pretty good already. I'm actually really happy with that. Again, I would make this a little bit different if I was to do it all over again on Photoshop, but Canva, it is a free browser-based software, so it does its job, and I'm really happy with the result we got. Now what we can do is just download it, go to this corner here, download, file type, I suggest you use PNG as suggested here, click download, and there we go, we are pretty much done. Now you can go ahead and use this anywhere you like. Again, I want to emphasize, this is the most basic of the basics you can get. Like, obviously this is not how I usually do my thumbnails, but this is the bare minimum you need to get started. You don't need Photoshop, you don't need to be super creative, you don't need to have a design degree. All you need is Canva or any other free software, really. And you need to start simple. You need to start learning the basics first, and then as you go on and making more videos, you will find ways to get more creative with your thumbnails, and you will find ways to make them look even more attractive and more true to your brand and yourself. So don't worry about it too much as of yet. I know so many people talk about how important the thumbnails are, and yes, they are extremely important, but even thumbnails like this one here right now are already like just good enough to get you going, okay? So this is the final result. We have the three most basic and necessary elements. We have the background, we have our subject, and we have the text that hopefully will support our title. If you like this thumbnail, I don't know. This is up to you to decide. Maybe I will change it later. This is actually something really important I need to talk about as well, is that it's okay to not have the best thumbnail yet. You can always go back and change it. Like, once you upload your video with the thumbnail, you can take a look at the analytics over the next couple days when it starts to gain some traction. And if you see that the click-through rate is not really good, you can make a fair judgment on your thumbnail or your title and then make adjustments based on that feedback you got from your analytics. So you can always go back and change it, which I have done a couple of times actually, even on this channel. So you need to remember that just test your thumbnails. It's always gonna be a learning experience. You're gonna learn as you go and get better. Yeah, now you have a thumbnail, and hopefully you have a video already as well. So if you wanna learn how to use your gaming video to grow your personal brand, then make sure to check out this video here. And other than that, if you enjoyed this video, then make sure you hit that like button. Subscribe with the notification bell on if you haven't yet. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. GG.